Rajasthan, the land of contrasts, where scorching desert merges into lush deciduous forests, where rivers, streams and lakes abound, where the mesmerizing folk dances and music have a mood and rhythm of their own. Rajasthan, the land of brave warriors around whom grew the most amazing legends of romance and heroism. Rajasthan, where exquisite palaces and history-laden forts enchant every traveler traveling through this land of legends. Rajasthan, truly a huge open-air museum where the relics of a golden past have been well preserved for the coming generations and the tourists both.
Very true. This land of legends impresses and fascinates each and every traveler that they want to come back here again and again. Just like me, tell you truth. Every now and then, I try to find excuses to come back to this place again and again. And this time also, I managed to find a perfect excuse, the reason being, this magnificent fort of Jhalawar, Gagran Fort, which caught my eye at the very first sight of it while traversing through this region, Hadoti region of Rajasthan, and compelled me to stop and have a close look at it. So here I am. Come, let's go and explore this yet another marvel of a golden past.
Gagran Fort, standing majestically on the crest of a hill at the confluence of the rivers Ahu and Kali Sindh, is surrounded by the water of these rivers on three sides, while on the fourth side, a deep moat provided it an unsurpassable barrier, thus completing its defenses and making it a fine example of Jal Durg, one of the nine types of forts as mentioned in Hindu Shastras. The defenses of the fort were further strengthened by deep forests all around and Mukundara range of hills standing erect just behind it. Situated among such natural environs, Gagran Fort is a unique example of merging strength with softness and bravery with beauty. These mighty entrance gates of the fort with protruding nails stand still and strong, personifying a wakeful guard, astonishingly capable to stop any invader. The very first historical spot that one comes across just after entering the fort is the Jauhar Kund. It is here that, to protect their self-respect and to save their dignity, the ladies of the fort had performed Jauhar, that terrible act of women folk of a fort choosing to die by immolating themselves rather than falling into the hands of the enemy. And here in this fort, this act was performed not once but thrice. Walking on the rampart of the fort in itself is an experience worth having. And then, from here, having a glimpse of the breathtakingly beautiful and serene surroundings of the fort takes the onlooker to wonderlands. It is from here you also get to see the snail-like movement of the life around the fort. The location of the main part of the fort itself is very striking. Having a look at it from down below, it seems like just looming out of a rock.
Rocks and rocks around. One wonders how in those old days people managed to build such huge and mammoth monuments, and that too without help of any modern day technology and machinery. But then that is Rajasthan. This is the way to go to the river down below, popularly known as Sainik Snan. It is said that soldiers used to use this route to go down and take their bath. Let's check it out.
This secret passage to the river down below is not only just an example of wartime planning, but it also gives us a feel of the great safety measures taken at this fort for the protection of the soldiers. From here, you can get a beautiful sight of turbulent Kali Sindh.
This is Rani Ki Baavi, where ladies used to come and take bath. Don't get ideas. Not me. I'm talking about the queens and princesses of those old times.
This totally separate, secure and secluded Bawri, the bathing place meant for the queens and princesses of the fort, presents yet another example of the great planning that had gone into building of this impregnable fort. This 7th to 8th century fort has been a witness to 14 great battles. In 1561, Gagron was captured by Akbar and the Mughals held it till 1715, when it was gifted to Bhim Singh, the ruler of Kota, who struck an alliance with the Rao of Amber and the Syeds in Delhi. This recently renovated part of the fort, seemingly having been the barracks of the soldiers, still carries the aura of the valorous Rajputs. This is the ventilation vent meant to safeguard the Barood Khana, situated underneath here. Every stone has a story. Story of their development and destruction. How simple, how true their stories are, of being magnificent mansions, splendid structure and furnished floor, everything extremely beautiful, but who can lessen the evident effect of time? Like all other forts, this fort too has got a few temples and places of worship. The walk through this mighty gate takes us to the residential part of the fort. Huge and mighty arches and gateways with idols of gods and goddesses on their entrances. we come to the palaces. The carvings on the balconies and majestic outer look of these compartments in itself gives a feel of the grandeur of these palaces in those times. Gagron, once a teeming city in medieval India, was ranked supreme in this part of Malwa, not only just for the bravery of its men, but also for its rich cultural activities, which is proved by the presence of this Rangshala within the precincts of the fort, popularly known as Akhara. The Gagron fort sets a true example of Sarva Dharma Sambhav, take every religion, every faith with same attitude. A testimony to this belief is the Dargah of Sufi Saint Mithi Shah, situated just outside the fort. This beautiful mausoleum of Mithi Shah, built in Hindu style of architecture, this is the second most important Dargah in whole of Rajasthan. If there is this Dargah situated on one side of the fort, on the other side of the fort, there is situated the monastery of great Saint Pipaji, who figures amongst the chief eight disciples of Guru Ramanand and was a contemporary of great Saint Kabirji.
यह आश्रम पीपा धाम नाम से जाना जाता है। यह गागरोन के महाराज श्री पीपाजी महाराज यहाँ हुए हैं, जो पहले राजा रहे और उनके अनेकों युद्ध भी हुए। वह जगतगुरु स्वामी श्री रामानंदाचार्य जी महाराज से दीक्षित हुए और दीक्षा लेने के बाद यहाँ संपूर्ण भारत में भक्ति का प्रचार करते हुए यहाँ पुनः स्थापित हुए। यहाँ स्थापित होने के बाद यह बराबर में जो समाधि दिख रही है, जो निर्माण कार्य हो रहा है इसका, यह वही स्थान है और तपस्थली के रूप में यहाँ गुफा है श्री पिपाजी महाराज की। यह भी समीप ही है, जो वट वृक्ष के पास में है। उत्तर दिशा में उनका किला है। ऐसा अक्सर नहीं पाया जाता कि जिस जगह प्रकट होते हैं संत वहीं प्रसिद्धि पाएं, लेकिन यह ऐसे महान सिद्ध हुए हैं।
Even today, this temple provides a feeling of purity to everyone who comes here.
So, that was the fort, a place worth to pay a visit. I'm quite impressed. What about you? Well, let's check it out. What more Jhalawar has to offer us. Come, let's go.
Far away from the glitter of big cities, Jhalawar is the world of simplicity and modest desires of the sinewy, hardy and sturdy farmers. While roaming through the narrow roads and by-lanes of the city, one comes face to face with the typical lifestyle of the people of the region. Kids playing on footpath, this old man lost in his sweet memories. Wrinkled face of Amma mirrors marks of bygone days. If man is busy serving his house and family, how can birds be behind? They have also begun making and decking up their tiny homes. Cute looking squirrel seems to be busy with her schedule and daily work, free from any fear. Everything is so calm and composed. Once the realm of Chalas, this state of Jhalawar boasts of having well-patronized music and drama in the early years. A testimony to which is the presence of Bhavani Natyashala, a reputed theatre of those times. It was also one of the most popular Parsi theatres of the country in state times.
Now, don't you think this is just amazing? Something unimaginable. Something unbelievable. Besides Gagron Fort, Jhalawar also houses this unique structure and architectural marvel. Bhavani Natyashala, built in 1921 by Maharaj Rana Bhavani Singh, once used to be a vibrant center for various performing arts like Parsi theater. But seems like now it is in a dire need of renovation and reactivation if we want to preserve our heritage.
Bhavani Natyashala, one of the most reputed theatres of yesteryears, was established in 1921 by Maharaja Bhavani Singh for promoting the performing artists of the region. In its heydays, this unique theatre was a hub of theatre activities and the great plays of all times, ranging from Shakuntalam to Shakespeare's classics, were staged here. Known as Zanana Khas, this is one of the most beautiful parts of the Garh Palace, which nowadays houses one of the oldest museums of Rajasthan, the Government Museum. Established in 1915 AD, the museum preserves some of the finest collections of paintings, rare manuscripts, idols, and beautiful statues of Lakshmi Narayan, Vishnu, Krishna, Ardhanarishwar, Nataraj, Trimurti, and many more. Its galleries are full of sculptures and architectural fragments of the 8th century city of Chandravati, as well as the sculptures and epigraphs from Jhalarapatan region.
This place, now a government museum, is yet another place in Jhalawar, housing abundant treasure of ancient Indian art, some of which date back about a millennium, if not more. Now this one is a 7th century AD relic of Lord Lakulish, a reincarnation of Lord Shiva, excavated at a distance of 3 kilometers away at Govindpura.
It is really a treat to watch such a huge collection of artifacts at one place. This palace, with an extraordinary architecture and interiors situated amongst the most amazing and serene surroundings, commonly referred as Koti, is the private domicile of ex-ruler's family. Within the precincts of this palace is situated yet another marvel of architecture, the Mahasati Mata Temple. The tomb and the walls of the temple made of marble yet again gives a feel of the expertise of the artisans of those days. The two chhatris built in front of the temple and the idols placed inside them further adds to its beauty. The aura of the temple situated in such serene surroundings gives an eternal solace to everyone coming here for Mahasati Mata's darshan. Unlike much of Rajasthan, the rocky but water-laden fertile landscape of Jhalawar provides a lush countryside which fascinates every traveller travelling through this part of the country.
What a drive! This 90-kilometer drive out here to Kolvi from Jhalawar, with the mosaic of green fields and water bodies, presents a splendid introduction with the pretty countryside of Jhalawar. It really is unlike other parts of Rajasthan. Why am I here? Reason is that it is here in Kolvi and around you find the only rock cut out caves of Rajasthan. Let's go and have a close look at these caves.
With just a short climb to the top, one comes face to face with the man-made ancient Buddhist caves carved on this desolate hillock of Kolvi village. A colossal figure of standing Buddha, the carved stupas and many sculptures in meditative posture are the most impressive structures in these Buddhist caves. These extraordinary Buddhist caves, numbering over 50, believed to belong to the 5th century, are of great importance, both archaeologically as well as historically, as they are the only rock-cut caves in Rajasthan and stand a witness to the existence of a flourishing civilization several centuries ago and the Buddhist influence in the region. From the doors of these caves, which mostly opened to the valley below, one can still have a stupendous view of forests and wilderness around. Stones are said to be heartless, but Kolvi stones appear contrary to this consideration. When one looks at them, they are possible enough to make a stone-hearted person feel emotional or passionate.
I say, this has been one of my most amazing experiences so far. You just need to be here to experience the feeling which one gets after coming face to face with such relics of our golden past. I am proud to be an Indian. I hope you too.
Although the erosion has taken its toll, but still the place gives a feeling of peace and a distance from the world of humans into serene nature and makes us believe that faith never dies but keeps alive even 1500 years after the monks prayed for Nirvana. It is said that Jalalabad, the city of bells, originally had 108 temples built over a few centuries, but today the finest amongst them is the 10th century Surya Temple, a replica of Konark Temple in Orissa, originally built in 813 AD by Maharaja Nagbhatta II, was later renovated in the year 1679 AD by Jhala Zalim Singh Diwan. The exterior walls of the temple are adorned with one of the finest carvings, statues and sculptures. The statues at the backside of the temple are the best examples of sculpture, and that is what makes it to be also known as Second Khajuraho. The shikhar is built in layers and the size of the pillars decreases as height increases, following a 7-story pillar format. The inner temple is a square shaped built in the Nagar style and has a shikhar. Though this is a sun temple, but the four-armed black stone idol of Padmanabhji in a standing posture is installed on a wooden throne. Like most of the ancient Indian temples, the columns and arches supporting the roof at the entrance of the temple are finely carved with images of gods, goddesses and other Hindu motifs. The ceiling of the mandap has carvings of statuettes of sages. This very unique architecture of Surya Temple makes it one of its own kind in entire Rajasthan. If there is a Surya Sun Temple, there has to be one dedicated to the moon. The Chandravati or Chandrabhaga temples located on the banks of the Chandrabhaga River here in Jhalarapatan are just that. The most famous of these temples are the Chandramuleshwar Temple, Sitaleswar Mahadev Temple, Kalika Devi Temple and Varaha Avatar Temple. At the entrance to the Chandramuleshwar temple stand two stone pillars carved from base to top. The intricately carved pillars and arched gateways are fine examples of the temple architecture and craftsmanship. The lower portion of the columns depict goddesses and their escorts in a finery rarely seen in Rajasthan. Most of the temples here are in ruins. Statues of Hindu gods and goddesses can be found in abundance here. Interesting legends about the foundation of these temples. However, these temples were actually built in the 6th century AD and lie scattered along the banks of the Chandrabhaga stream. The river Chandrabhaga is considered holy by the people residing in this part of Rajasthan. A large number of devotees come here to have a dip in this holy river. Owing to its yet unexplored treasures of history, exquisite prehistoric cave paintings, massive forts, thickly wooded forests and exotic variety of wildlife, Jhalawar today is one of the most coveted destinations for the lovers of adventure and scholars both.
With this visit, to centuries-old heritage of ours brings us to the end of this expedition of exploring this land of Jhalas, Jhalawar. This journey, full of ecstasy, casts an everlasting spell on even the most seasoned travelers traveling through this land of legends. I enjoyed my trip very much and hope you too. And goodbye till we meet again.